I hate kids. They're barely human. They're loud. Obnoxious. They never listen. They're never quiet in a movie theater or anywhere, really. And they just generally, overall, have absolutely no idea what it is they're doing. Like, how does anybody love kids? Okay, yeah, forget everything I just said. How can you not love that face? Aww. So what is Usagi Drop really? Brilliant? Masterful? Amazing beyond all words and compare? Not really. But there is one thing, one very important thing, that it is. It's simple, yet elegant. Other shows have action, adventure, space battles, mech battles, explosions, and many other glorious things that on any other day I would praise until hell or high water. Well, most of the time. Usagi Drop has none of that. None of that! And is still one of the best shows of the past year. Okay, so what the hell is this show about anyway? Well, this show is about a man named Daikichi and a little girl named Rin. And that's really the most important thing. Daikichi and Rin. You got that? Okay, because it's about to get a lot more complicated. So you know, you do get that. Daikichi Rin, right? Right? Alright, here we go. So, through some very weird family history, Rin is the daughter of Daikichi's grandfather, who recently passed away, leaving absolutely no one to care for the young Rin. Still with me? Okay. Yes, I know technically that Rin is now Daikichi's aunt, and there's like a 25-year age difference there, but try not to think about that. It's always best to look past such complicated things. Anyways. But because there is no one left in the family to take care of her, or no one willing to take care of her, Daikichi decides to do the brave and noble thing and... You know what? Just watch. But this seems like a very simple task that Daikichi has now. I mean, how hard can it be to take care of a little girl? Am I right?
It's more difficult than you will ever know.
But I'm sure Daikichi can handle it. And that's the most important thing in a nutshell. The plot has no overarching storyline, instead opting to go for individual stories about the pair's lives and how they must now cope with each other. Because seriously, let's just look at it from Daikichi's perspective for a moment. You go from being able to work however long you want to basically however much you physically can, so that you can earn as much money as you can, so that you can spend all this money on basically just yourself, to, now, being forced into a 9-to-5 job because you have to go and drop Rin off at school and pick Rin up again from school, which means you possibly are going to be in a position where you get less money than you were before, and out of that less money, you now have to pay for an extra person, for food and clothing and who knows what the hell else. The show is really aimed at more of an older audience, rather than the teenage shonen type BELIEVE kind of shows. And it's not because it's trying to warn people.
This is what will happen when you have kids.
But it's more so just like, so yeah, there's this thing that happens in people's lives called parenthood. Not a lot of anime like to cover this, so we're going to try.
And it's gonna blow your mind.
There is, however, one thing. One thing that without this show would be absolutely nothing. Rin. Rin is quite simply the greatest kid ever. Seriously, she is. She has a multitude of strengths and is a hell of a lot more mature than a lot of even adults I know, not that that's a hard thing to do nowadays. But it is still a great achievement. She's also considerate, thoughtful, and basically the most adorable little thing ever. I suppose the other surprising thing about this whole show is not the plot or the story or anything like that, but who animated it? As it was Production IG that took the reins for this one. Oh yeah, that's not a typo or something I typoed and then read aloud to a camera thing. The same people who animated this... and also animated this... animated this. Freaking beautiful. For a studio that's really well known for its highly detailed and fluid animation, it's really nice to see something so simple performed by them. And it really shows you the versatility of the entire studio when they can do such a range of themes and genres so well. Okay, yes, they've had their little hiccups here and there, some things haven't been that great, but most of the time, you really can't go wrong with them. I also really like the style of animation they chose, because they could have been super realistic with it, but then it wouldn't have fit the tone. So instead they opted for a more pastel, childlike style of animation, which not only fits really well with Rin's personality, but with the show as a whole. Anything else? No dub yet, nothing there, so yeah. I think that pretty much covers it. I guess that is a small problem with something so simple. You just can't go into glorious amounts of detail about it because it's really just there. Especially if you don't want to go into spoilers because, you know, everything is a spoiler. That's cardinal rule number 2, by the way. Following the one about endings being paramount, which, you know, they are. But enough about that, trying to be much more grand and verbose. On to the final verdict. Usagi Drop is a rare kind of show that's able to capture your heart with just how simplistic yet realistic and heartwarming it all is. It is a simple tale of two beings who come together to make a family and deal with all the ups and downs contained therein. The pluses are, again, in its simplicity. You don't need to think about this one very hard to read and understand what's going on at any given time, and the episodic nature of the show helps ease that a lot, as every episode is self-contained and fairly self-explanatory. Rin is an absolute delight to view on screen, and her interactions with Daikichi are either unbelievably adorable or excessively cute, both of which I approve of. The show also continues to prove the versatility of Production IG and their works as one of my favorite production studios that's making anime today, being able to keep their high standards of animation, but apply it to a much more simple style than any other shows they have done of late. The downsides to the show, well, there really aren't that many. The show is by no means perfect, but there are no glaring issues anywhere to behold. Which means all that remains is the knowledge that if you have absolutely no interest in a story of this kind, then it's not going to be a show for you. Also, although you may not consider this a big deal, but really, I felt the show was cut just a tad too short, and that was disappointing. Maybe it's because I just got spoiled on it, but cutting a show off at only 11 episodes is sad to me. Just 12 would have been fine, 13 would have been awesome, and hell, beyond that would have been amazing. Sure, as many people keep trying to spoil to me, the manga continues from where the anime left off, and does it lead to the best of places, but hell, that doesn't mean Production IG couldn't have changed things as they went along. Granted, I will admit, it is better to have ended on a very nice and high note than to start strong and end crappily, because as we know, the ending is paramount. In my opinion though, if you are a slice of life drama kind of person, you really, like really have to check out this show now. Cause it truly is one of those ones that's just gonna make you feel all nice, warm, and fuzzy inside while you watch it. Though if you are a little antsy about the whole parenting thing and, you know, that's fine, then just give it a preview. And of course, if absolutely nothing I've said in this video holds absolutely any interest to you, then skip it, you quite possibly heartless person. And I don't mean that, I'm just making a very logical statistic there, you heartless person. So, ladies, gentlemen, and others, that's it from me. I hope you have enjoyed, and until next time, stay frosty, everyone. Later.